Ever wondered if an old PC could become your own private cloud? In this video, I'll show you how I turned a dusty old desktop into a fully functional TrueNAS powered server for photos, videos, IP cams, and more. The idea started when my mom's Google storage ran out. Instead of buying more cloud storage, I thought, what if I build a NAS at home? I had an old HP Compaq PC lying around, and a big idea. I upgraded the PC with two 2TB NAS drives and a 120GB SSD for the OS. After deep cleaning everything, including inside the power supply, I got creative with mounting the SSD in the CD-ROM bay. The PC refused to boot from USB, so I installed TrueNAS SCALE on the SSD using a virtual machine and a USB to SATA adapter. Once done, I plugged it back into the PC, and boom, it booted. After connecting the PC via Ethernet, TrueNAS got a local IP. I accessed the web interface and set up a mirrored storage pool for redundancy, so if one drive fails, the other still has everything. To sync photos from my parents' phones, I used Syncthing. It works quietly in the background. Every photo or video is instantly backed up to the NAS, no cloud needed. I used PhotoPrism, an AI-powered media manager that organizes everything with face and object detection. It even tags locations and people for easy searching. I then migrated my mom's entire Google Photos using Google Takeout. I used EXIF tool to inject metadata from JSON files back into the photos, so PhotoPrism could sort them correctly. To access the NAS securely from anywhere, I set up Tailscale VPN. Now I can connect to the NAS from abroad, like I'm still on my home network. I added my IP cameras using Shinobi, an open-source NVR. It streams and records video to the NAS, and yes, even works in the dark. Next step, adding a UPS backup. That way, the NAS router and cameras stay online, even during power cuts. From a dusty old desktop to a feature-packed NAS, this build was part tech, part family project. If I can do it, so can you. Stay curious. To explore my project in more detail, feel free to check out the full documentation. Can't find it? Just scan the QR code on the screen. It'll take you right there. Thanks for your time, Kachow.